Hello and welcome back. Myself, Ken and Carl were invited as speakers to the Vintage Computer Festival East, the big event for vintage computer nerds in that corner of the woods. So we made our way to Wall, New Jersey, straight south of New York. But on our way to the event, I wanted to make a pilgrimage to my old office in Bell Labs. My time at Bell Labs in the early 1990s will forever remain a high point in my career. Bell Labs is the place where the transistor and the laser were invented. I met many a Nobel Prize winner and physics and engineering celebrities while I was there. The brain power per square foot was just incredible, and we were miles ahead of the rest of the field. Sadly, Bell Labs is no more, but the gigantic Holmdale building where I was is still a landmark of architecture.
This is an absolutely huge building. It goes on and on and on and on and on and on. And it's actually four buildings in a glass shell. So the name of your office had which building it was, 1, 2, 3, 4, or east, west, north, I can't remember. To think that they wanted to demolish this, I can't believe it. My office was third floor. Oh, it's still offices. It still looks like the old Bell Labs. No kidding. So mine was down the hallway here, and then the artificial intelligence people were two hallways down, and the fab was on the fifth floor or the sixth floor, because we were actually growing crystals and laser diodes and poisoning everything with lucky. We had arsine and phosphine and all that good stuff. It's a glass elevator that just all goes to the top. It's such a beautiful place. And it was a sunken reception. They might have filled it in. It still exists. This is the main entrance, right, with a sunken building. And then you have the lake, which was used as a coolant for the lab, for the fab. And then back there you have the transistor, also known as the water tower. I think that's the transistor. That's the main entrance. It's the only remnant of Bell Labs. It's called the Bell Market. So they kept a little bit of the name for the folklore, I guess. And I think that was a cafeteria, and it's now the Bar Bella. good name. They could have called it the Bar Bells, would have been even better. Such a magnificent building.
Anyhow, so much for nostalgia. Time to head to the InfoAge Museums, the site of VCF. It's actually quite a historical site, which used to be the radio receiving station on the East Coast for Marconi. It now houses a collection of small museums, more on this later, and our dear VCF East.
This guy's really cool too, Andy Geppert.
Oh, the core memory stuff, like you can write on his little magnet.
I'll take him down and get him on. Maybe not.
see you guys.
Long time no see.
First, we're going to enter our first of the two values. So let's put in 0F, 0F. The first value, and that is the second binary value. Now the program is ready to do the addition. If I hit that, we just do it immediately. We're going to single step through it. So first, we have to take 8 clocks to fetch the instruction and know what it is. So we've done that, and now we're going to execute the instruction. So we get that first value I put in, and the second value I put in, and now we're going to do, bit by bit, we're going to do the logical, figure out whether it's a 1 or a 0. So it's really exclusive OR, right?
Okay.
And then you'll figure out, if there's a carry, you'll put a bit in the next one over. So that was the first cycle, so we've still got 4 carries there. So we have to do it again. Now we only have 1 carry. Now there's another carry. Now there's no carries, so we fetch the next instruction.
Beautiful blinking lights. So this has the original lamps, or it has one of your boards in it?
It's my board, but...
It's your board?
Yeah.
Yes. Are those LEDs?
No. I went back to incandescent because I couldn't get LEDs to look right.
Are you on the mouse today?
That's the board that I did.
It's fantastic.
Because the IBM method is these little green boards like this, with 16 lamps hanging off of it on flexible leads. And you have to force all 16 into the honeycomb at the same time to push it in.
IBM should give you a bonus.
Here's 2 gigs. Here's what replaced SNS. It was announced in 65, so basically same era as the 360, same kind of cards.
Blinking lights.
Right, dual bank memories. I figured out and wrote it up better on Big Book of America hardware.
I see a cow pump actually working with all the pens.
This was the size paper was intended to work with. You can see the other tractor feeds, but I just used the printer paper because I got a ton of it. Yeah, this width is just not made anymore.
Yeah. And then you actually can fill it with liquid ink.
Well, there's some that fill liquid ink, some at ballpoint, different inserts.
Yeah, these are the Fisher Space Pen pressurized ink.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. It also had just normal ballpoint. Uh-huh. You had...
Yeah, the whole thing.
Yeah, felt tips.
Uh-huh.
And then you had the liquid ink. And then these came in different tip widths to control how wide your lines were. And then, of course, you had your different ink colors.
These are harder to find.
Yes. I've never seen somebody with the whole accoutrement of pens and things. Well done.
Yeah, so.
Awesome sauce.
So this is not the right door.
I see a almost space-looking helmet. Look at this XY military XY tracing table. Sorry, I get distracted easily.
Soviet Air Force high altitude helmet.
Okay, that would do. Some nefarious things here. Some interesting hardware. Oh, that will do. Carbon arc. Lots of jeeps. One that tries on rails.
driving.
Oh, that would be cool in my garden. Yeah. Okay, well, oh, it keeps going.
Yes.
It's still not the museum we want.
No.
What? That's another museum.
And they, yeah, and they've got other buildings on the circuit.
And they're trying to clean it. And they're literally chipping it off and clean.
Weird vehicles. And the model ship. Beautiful. Beautiful. Oh, that's another impressive place.
Two Hollywood movie stars here.
Core memory, wire memory. Transformer memory.
My favorite is Selectrons. I want to see Selectrons.
Okay, let's go find Selectrons.
Two new people.
Oh, there's a reproduction of the ENIAC room. Oh, and then they have a working UNIVAC. Wow.
This is 1-7. This is 10-17. And it's all still on. It's not 10, even though it says 0.
Oh, that's a pretty one.
Two of them, both of them?
Yeah, think about
it. Turn the other one on the top.
We got somewhat distracted and we never got to my HP 1000. We will. It's a it's to help farmers. I think it's milk production. Yeah, yes, it calculates it's
in dry matter and silage and all that.
Yeah, yeah, it calculates
pasture code,
pound of milk and weight of cow.
Damn, I love this air data computer.
And then we get
here.
Oh, yeah, that's a beautiful.
Yeah, there's a bigger one.
This one has electronics in it. It's cheating.
Oh, I see. Maybe it is all electronic. I see ear trains, though.
So the
ear servos.
Yes, there's a transition where they put some piece in is analog computing. So progressively, they get more and more electronics. And I just bought my chip tester pro. So I can test DRAMs and all that good stuff. Mine. We gave our Apollo panel on Sunday, which went great with a lot of questions. They have not yet released the footage of it. Instead, I'll link to the VCF YouTube channel where it should appear eventually. But that was just the beginning of our East Coast tour. Stay tuned for the visit of the System Source Museum in Maryland, the Computer Museum of America in Atlanta, a private tour of the Cape Canaveral Space Force Station by Carl, and a tour of the Cape Kennedy NASA Space Center. See you soon!